Hi everyone, Darren from DreyTech Australia and New Zealand. The DreyTech Vigor 2862 series has been one of our best-selling routers since 2017, replacing the Vigor 2860 series before that, and it's not hard to see the reasons for their popularity. Here we had a business class router with a built-in DSL modem for either ADSL or VDSL with performance and features that businesses and plenty of home users were looking for, including up to 4 WANs, 32 VPN tunnels, including up to 16 SSL VPNs, VLANs, Voice over IP, QoS, Central AP Management, and Central Switch Management. It was awesome, but it was time to make it even better. Presenting the Vigor 2865 series, which includes the non-wireless Vigor 2865, the Vigor 2865 AC, which features dual band 802.11ac Wi-Fi with up to 400 megabits per second on the 2.4 gigahertz band and up to 867 megabits per second on the 5 gigahertz band. Also featured is Wave 2 2x2 MIMO, allowing two simultaneous wireless spatial streams. And the Vigor 2865 VAC has the same Wi-Fi features, but also includes two FXS ports for VoIP. While these three models will support 3G or 4G USB modems, we also have two models with built-in LTE modems, which allows them to connect to 3G or 4G with just a SIM. These models actually feature two SIM slots, which allows for a second SIM to be installed to wait on standby in case there's ever a problem with the primary LTE connection. So here we have the non-wireless Vigor 2865L. Those antennas you see there are for the LTE connection, not for the Wi-Fi for your local area network. And the Vigor 2865LAC. This one features the same 802.11ac Wi-Fi as the other Vigor 2865 series models. So what's new? Let's start with a look at some of the physical changes. On the front, we see we still have a DSL port for an ADSL or VDSL connection. It's just swapped over to the far right-hand side now. Another thing that stands out straight away is we now have 5 LAN ports instead of 4. We also see that the USB ports have changed sides as well, as has the Ethernet WAN port, which as before can be configured to either act as a WAN or a LAN port. One big change there is on the 2862 model, if you wanted to connect to a wireless ISP or wireless hotspot, it meant sacrificing that as a WAN port. You see here it's either Ethernet WAN or a 2.4 or a 5 GHz Wi-Fi connection. We couldn't do all three at once. That also meant having to go through this process if you wanted to connect to a mobile phone's wireless hotspot in an emergency situation and then change it back again later once your Ethernet WAN came back online. In the Vigor 2865 series though, now we can have both or all three at once. We see here we can keep our Ethernet WAN and have the 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz WAN set to be always on or failover. That also means we can have up to 6 WANs on wireless models compared to 4 on the old Vigor 2862 series. The LTE model sacrificed one of the USB ports for the built-in LTE modem, but it still allows for up to 6 WANs on the Vigor 2865LAC model. If you don't need to connect to 3G or 4G using a compatible 3G or 4G USB modem, the USB port or ports, as is the case on the non-LTE models, can also be used to connect USB hard drives or flash drives or a USB printer, or connect the DreyTech DT201U USB thermometer to monitor the device temperature. Performance-wise, comparing to the older 2862 series, we've gone from up to 500 megabits per second to 800 megabits per second NAT performance, which is 1.6 times faster. We have 3.5 times faster IPsec performance, up from 85 megabits per second to 300 megabits per second, and SSL performance is nearly 3 times faster at up to 130 megabits per second compared to 45 megabits per second. But wait, it gets even better. The Vigor 2865 series also features hardware acceleration, which improves NAT and IPsec performance even more. The hardware accelerator can process up to 8,000 NAT and routing connections, delivering up to 940 megabits per second with the Ethernet WAN and up to 1.3 gigabits per second combined throughput with both Ethernet and the DSL WAN. Around the back, we still have SMA connectors for our antennas, which allows higher gain antennas to be fitted instead of the standard units if you find you want to extend the range. DreyTech have the ANT1205 and ANT1207 available, or the directional ANT2520. All models can also be rack mounted using the DR101 rack mount bracket available separately. Okay, let's log into the web user interface and have a look around. Once logged in, we have our DreyTech dashboard, which gives us a summary of what's going on. Up the top here, we have a nice little graphic showing us which ports are online and even if our Wi-Fi is broadcasting. Down here under IPv4 internet access, we can see if we're online and what our IP address is. Under interface, we get little graphics to show us which ports are connected, and we can expand some of those out for more detail. Similarly, under security, we can see how many VPNs are connected. If we expand out My Vigor, we can see which optional licenses have been activated and when they expire. That includes subscriptions for the WCF, that's the Web Content Filter, App Enforcement License, and the free DRAID DDNS license. Up here, we have the usual quick start wizards to make it easier to get online, set up a VPN, or set up the Wi-Fi. WAN general setup I showed briefly earlier. Here we can configure up to 6 WANs, and each interface can be set to always on or failover to come online as needed. Under LAN VLAN, we can have up to 16 VLANs. Bind IP to MAC is where you can reserve IP addresses in the DHCP pool for particular devices on your network. It can do LAN port mirroring. Down under routing, we can configure static routes. Load balance route policy allows binding particular traffic to a particular interface, and you can have up to 50 of those. Down the bottom here, we can give each rule a priority, which can be above or below the routes in the routing table. In NAT is where we go to redirect any ports or set up a DMZ. Under that, we have the hardware acceleration settings I mentioned earlier, which can be either enabled or disabled. And we also have options of whether we want it to apply to NAT or IPsec or both, and which protocols we'd like to include. Hardware acceleration on IPsec increases performance from 290 megabits per second up to 800 megabits per second, which is up to 2.8 times faster. Hardware acceleration will automatically apply to the first 16 tunnels to connect. If one of those tunnels disconnects, the next in line will drop in and so on. The firewall is object-based and we create our objects or object groups down here under Objects setting. CSM or Content Security Management is where you can create policies to block certain applications. There's also the subscription service I mentioned earlier, which you can activate under the APPE signature upgrade. Below that, you can set URL filters. Under Web Content Filter Profile, there's also a subscription service for that if you want to take the pain out of the process. Otherwise, you can create your own profiles. If I click on one here, you can see you can set keywords, or down here you can block or allow according to general categories. Down here you can set the message people will see if they go to a blocked web page. If you have clever teenagers like mine and they don't like having their access restricted, this is one very good reason to change the default admin password on the router, or suddenly every website you go to will have a smarty pants message on it instead, which they think is hilarious. And we can change the admin password down here under System Maintenance Administrator Password. Under Bandwidth Management, you can create session limits and bandwidth limits. QoS is also featured, as is App QoS. So here we can select applications we want to prioritize with a single click. VPN and remote access, you can create up to 32 LAN-to-LAN VPNs or remote dial-in VPN profiles. Just remember it's 32 in total of both LAN-to-LAN and dial-in VPN profiles. You can max out the number of profiles of each created, but only 32 will be able to connect at once. And hardware acceleration, as I mentioned earlier, will only apply to the first 16 to connect. Down the bottom here, you can download the free DreyTech Smart VPN client for different operating systems. VPN trunk management allows load balancing VPNs over two WAN links, which is handy for increasing VPN bandwidth or adding redundancy. So if one of the WANs goes down, all of the traffic will automatically switch to the remaining link. Down here, we have our wireless settings for both 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. Under System Maintenance, Configuration Backup allows us to create a backup file we can restore easily if something goes wrong or if we need to replace the router for some reason. You can also create a schedule to do that automatically. Down here we can reboot, and under that is where we go to upgrade or backup the firmware. Diagnostics has a bunch of tools and tables to aid in troubleshooting. And under Central Management we can manage up to 8 VPNs. Central AP Management can look after 20 Vigor APs. And Central Switch Management can manage up to 10 Vigor switches. The Vigor 2865 series can also be managed using the Vigor ACS2 or Vigor ACS3 central management applications. So that is DreyTech's Vigor 2865 series router range, which come with a 2-year back-to-base warranty. For more information about all DreyTech products, please check out our website at www.dreytech.com.au. If you have any questions, please comment below, or you can send us an email to sales@dreytech.com.au, or just give us a call on 02983888899. Links below to the Vigor 2865 series product pages. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe below. Give the bell a click too if you'd like a notification of new videos as they go up. Thanks and bye for now.